When we first open LibreOffice Impress, we see the title bar here at the top of the screen. The title of our document is Untitled 1. That is the default title until we save it and give it a name. We also have the Minimize, Maximize, and Close buttons here on the right. And on the left, I've got a drop down with the Minimize, Maximize, or Unmaximize here because we are maximized, and Move, and a few other options. Below the title bar, we've got the menu bar. The menu bar has various drop downs that we will be using throughout this video tutorial series. After the menu bar, we've got toolbars. Now, this might look like one single toolbar to you, but if you look carefully, we're going to see some dots right here. And when I hover over those dots, my mouse changes from an arrow to a hand in this case, showing us that we can grab this and move it around. The handles are gone. To grab it when it's floating like this, you grab the title of the toolbar, and I can place that right back to where it was, move it back in. Right clicking on the toolbar, I'm clicking the standard toolbar. There's our name here at the top. We can lock this position, so now it can't be moved from there. To get to that context menu again, just right click anywhere in that toolbar. We can unlock it. We can also close the toolbar. We still see the presentation toolbar, but our standard toolbar is missing. Actually just turned off. We'll go into View, Toolbars, and turn back on the standard toolbar, and it's back. With these toolbars, there's also one here at the bottom. Here I have it floating. We can dock them to the left side to change it. Grab the toolbar handle. We can move it to the right side or just leave it here floating. I'm going to move this back down to the bottom and over to the far left. On the left side here, we've got the Slides pane. The Slides pane is a little preview of all the slides we have. We only have one at the moment. We can adjust this a little bit. I can pull it out to about there and minimize it to about there. To hide it, I'll click this button here that's about halfway up. Here we see it's hidden. I can open it back up. And if I don't want to look at it at all, I'll click this X and it's closed. To open it back up, we go into View, Slide Pane, and we can also close it from that view as well. In the center, we've got the workspace for our slide. We are in the normal view. We'll talk about these other views in future tutorials. For now, we're going to stick to the normal view. And over on the right, we have the sidebar, which works similar to the slide pane, meaning we can make it a little bit bigger, a little bit smaller, or somewhere in between. We've got the hide button and show button. Clicking on the buttons here on the left will hide just the tools and bring it back out, but leave us these buttons. And we'll be looking at these in more detail in future tutorials. The side panel is a little different than the slide pane, meaning we can move this out and have it floating. I can dock it to the left side here or move it back to the right where it was. We cannot do that with the slides pane. That is locked to the left side. We can turn off the sidebar just as we can the slides pane by going into View and checking sidebar. It's turned on. I'm turning it off and back on. I'll stretch it out a little bit. Down at the bottom, we've got the drawing toolbar, and below that, we've got the status window. Now, down in this lower left-hand corner will give us a status on what we're doing, if anything. Right now, we're not doing anything, so there's no status. But if I click inside one of these auto layouts, we see that we are editing the text in paragraph 1, row 1, column 1. This next item here tells us the position we are at. Right now, it's giving us the position of the auto layout text box. If I click outside of that, it gives us the arrow position. Up in the far left corner, it's 0, 0. If I could get into that corner perfectly, I'm getting pretty close. Over to the right, it's telling us 10.95 and 0 because the American default is 8.5 by 11 inch paper. I'm over at the 11. Going down to the bottom left corner, we are at 0, 8.5. And the far right corner showing us that we have 8.5 by 11 inch paper, and we're in the lower right corner. This next group of numbers is for the auto layout box in this case. If we had some shapes on there, it would be telling us our shape size. In this case, our shape is 9.92 by 4.79. If I click on the top one, we see 9.92 by 1.38. So it's 1.38 down and 9.92 from left to right. This default, this is for the master slides. We'll talk about that in the next video, maybe the following video after that, pretty soon though. And the last thing in this bottom corner is for adjusting the size. We can make it smaller or larger. And if it gets too small and you want it to be full screen real quick, just click this fit to screen button and it fits in with a best fit, whether that's horizontally or vertically. In this case, we're seeing our page at 84%. So those are the basics behind the windows of LibreOffice Impress. In the next video, we're going to start a presentation. If you like these videos, please tell a friend.